New World Update 1.03 has been released and is due to install tonight at 10 p.m. Pacific time. Nice little message. Greetings, adventurers. With this update, we have laid the final groundwork for the server transfer feature. We've also included a swath of bug fixes, thanks to all those who helped us track down these issues through the reports on the official New World forums. Before we dive into the details and exactly how the server transfer system works, our plan to roll out to all regions, and our list of bug fixes, we wanted to thank everyone who has supported New World in our first few weeks after launch. To show our appreciation for your patience, we're granting all players the Stoic in-game title. This title is meant to thank all those who, as the title description states, showed solid resolve in the face of epic wait times. The title will be automatically granted to your character and can be equipped by navigating to the character menu, selecting the Bio tab, and selecting Change in the title section of the screen. It may take up for a day for the Stoic title to appear in the list of available titles. We've also added the waiting emote to the in-game store for free as an additional thank you. To claim the emote, navigate to your in-game store and select the emotes tab, where you'll find the waiting emote available for free. Emotes are account bound, so you only need to claim it once on your Steam account, even if you have two characters. So diving into it, we're looking at the character transfer feature, and they say, while we want everyone to find their long-term home in Eternum as soon as possible, we also want to ensure that the process is safe and ready for everyone to use. We've been hard at work on the feature and testing it for the past 2 weeks, but because this feature is brand new, we've decided to take a safe, incremental approach to rolling out transfers to all players. When all worlds are back online from downtime, our plan is to monitor the framework we created without turning transfers on immediately. Once we have confirmed that the framework holds up to scale, we will turn on character server transfers in the Utopia world first, in the AP Southeast region. We will closely monitor transfers in this world, and if anything out of the ordinary occurs, our team will need to make manual interventions. If all goes well, we'll turn it on for the rest of the AP Southeast region and continue monitoring. If after 8 hours our team hasn't discovered any issues, we will fully deploy character server transfers to the other regions. Thank you to our AP Southeast players for helping us ensure this feature is ready for the worldwide rollout. And thank you to everyone for your understanding and patience. Please stay tuned to Play New World and our forums for the latest updates and this YouTube channel. Please review the video and FAQ below so you can understand how the transfer process will work, the limitations, and how it impacts your character. Each player will receive one free character transfer token. So some general notes. The way it's going to work is you're going to need to log into your character, which does mean waiting in queue. So if there's a queue and you're on a server with a 5,000 queue, you're waiting to be able to transfer out of that server. You're going to have to go to the store in the game and claim the character transfer token as if you're buying it, but it should be for free. Before you do this and you actually go through the process, you have to leave your company. You have to remove any active trading post sale or buy orders you have, and you must be in a sanctuary, which is a settlement or an outpost. Apparently, when you do it, you're going to keep your levels, your masteries, your titles, all that. So your character is basically the same. Your inventory and your storage is all the same. And your currency actually goes with you. I was shocked about that one. Didn't know if they'd let you do that. You're also going to obviously keep your house and any quests. Your company gets destroyed if you're the owner or you lose all access to it, basically. You have to make a new company on the new world or join a new company on the new world. Obviously, anything that you had for sale or whatever, you have to get rid of as part of the process. And your friends list, shockingly enough, is server-based. Now, there are some limitations on where you can transfer. You can go to any world in your region except ones that are full, ones that are in maintenance, or ones where you have an existing character, which, thankfully, we won't be able to bug that out and bring characters from multiple factions to one zone. That could be very bad. Now, they do say that if you screw up and you transfer to the wrong place, you can transfer again at a later time, but it'll require an additional token. Right now, they say, our team will continue monitoring world populations, queue times, and will evaluate the need for an additional wave of server transfer tokens to be given out for free. After we are sure players have had plenty of time to find the right server for them, we will later make the server transfer tokens available for purchase in the store. We'll give notice ahead of time when tokens are changing to a paid service. So looking at some of the miscellaneous things they fixed, they fixed the issue with the tier 4 and tier 5 staffs not working right. That's great. They fixed an issue causing the abandoned event notification to still be there even after they fixed it last week. We'll see how that goes in the future. They fixed an issue where the titles and the achievements were still not working and rolling over to uninitialized. Again, this is the second time they fixed that. Sadly, they sadly fixed an issue where chests were giving too many refining agents. This makes me sad. Adjusted the volume on the splash screen. Thank you so much. That is so loud. It deafens me. I can hear it from across the house. Finally, they're still working in war performance, and they put in some things to help them monitor it on their side. So apparently it's become a larger issue. As always, Dog Thulu would love it if you would scratch his itches and like, comment, subscribe,